Middlesex recover after Robinson sends stumps soaring. Sussex had another decent day with the bat, led by a first ton in Sussex White for Tom Alsop, to play their way to 354 for 6 at the end of the first day at the First Central County Ground. George Garton and Ollie Robinson were in the middle at the start of the second day, having already shown what they can do with the bat. 400 was in sight for the hosts. Garton returned in determined form, unbeaten overnight on 37. He wasted little time bringing up his half century. Just the return to action he was looking for. His side went on their way to taking control of the match. That was the end of the road for the England T20 international, frustrated with himself as he flashed at Anderson, only to edge through to White. The innings were starting to look like it was coming to an end. Just one of Beard's stumps left in the ground when Afridi was done with them. Anderson left them with just one more wicket. Robinson outcaught by Bamber for 18. And they were unable to make it through to 400. Crane out, caught in the deep off the bowling of Afridi. Sussex all out for 392. They may have been denied 400 runs, but Sussex wandered off proud of their first innings return, led by Allsop's 113, while Orr had been unfortunate to depart for 99, their cause massively helped by the lower order 53 of Garton. Anderson had been the pick of the bowlers with 3 for 88. And Sussex had more to enjoy when they picked up the ball for the first time. Robson left Robinson to remove his off stump unchallenged, just 4 balls into the innings. Stoneman tried to get Middlesex going, but he too was succumbed with the score still below 50. Garton added a wicket to his half century, the opener out for 26. That left Middlesex in a spot of bother at lunch, the score 44 for 2, still 348 in arrears. And it wasn't going to get much better for the visitors. White out for 6, caught by Rizwan off Hunt. Hanscom followed with a score still below 50, another ill-advised leave, another off stump knocked back by England's Ollie Robinson. Middlesex stabilised under the watch of Holden and Simpson, who finally got the visitors' innings up and running in earnest. First to move past 50, and soon enough to a 50 partnership. 3 runs then took them to 3 figures. This was much better from Middlesex, even if they did still have a small mountain to climb. A Simpson's 6 was a defiant shot, this pairing proving crucial to the visitors. And that had carried him to the cusp of 50, a mark reached off 83 balls, with a single off Clark. Holden had really found his feet too. Hunt cleared over the leg side to bring up the 100-run partnership. The shot that took the score to 150 was a little more measured though, Middlesex fighting back before tee. And Holden would reach his half century before the break, scored off 78 balls, his side thankful for his contribution. They headed in at 162 for 4. After putting on such a defiant show, Robinson brought Simpson's innings to an end on 71, yet another stump removed. They found their way to 200, still under pressure, but the deficit was dropping. Holman, not shy to get his innings started, 6 runs off Garton, getting him underway. But at the other end, Holden would go, bowled behind his legs by Mason Crane, 4 wickets left now. Anderson joined Holman in the middle, and once again, Sussex were kept at bay. Both men matched each other stride for stride, up to 250 when Anderson fired a flat 6 over the leg side. After 76 balls together, they put on 50 unanswered runs, a dismissive boundary from Holman taking them to the mark. And Holman would have a 50 before the end of the day, scored pretty quickly off 64 balls. His 7th boundary got him there. They were just 16 shy of 300 when bad light brought an end to the day. The threat of the follow-on had evaporated. They were now just 108 behind, with 4 wickets in hand. A pretty even day then. Middlesex probably slightly the happier of the two sides, parity not too far off after a horror start with the bat. Sussex will return on day 3 looking for the final few wickets, hoping Middlesex can't chip much more off their lead.